Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data, and in this video you'll learn 10 awesome things you can do with Google Sheets. These will help you save time, clean up your data, and even create simple dashboards. Some of these are quick wins, while others show you how to connect Sheets with other tools like Google Forms and Looker Studio. Okay, let's jump in and get started. Conditional formatting is a great way to make important data stand out in your sheet. You can quickly see patterns, outliers, or errors by applying a color scale. To do this, we select the cells we want to use. For this spreadsheet, I'm going to select the revenue column. Now let's choose Format and Conditional Formatting. And let's select color scale. We can now see higher values are highlighted with a darker green, while lower values are white and light green. We can also change this by selecting one of the other default options. Now lower values are highlighted. Okay, let's change this back. Now that we're using conditional formatting to highlight important values, we might want to limit the number of rows included in our spreadsheet. To do this, we're going to add a filter. Filters let you focus on particular rows in your sheet. Let's select the column we want to use for our filter. Let's select the status column. Now let's choose data. And then create a filter. We can now select the small filter icon in the first row to apply a filter to our sheet. For example, if we just want to view rows with a value of gold, we can click Clear and then select Gold. Now let's click OK. Our sheet has updated, so we're only seeing rows where the status column has a value of gold. And here's a pro tip. If you want a quick way to use this filter again, you can choose Data and select Save as Filter View. Now we can name our filtered view. Let's name this one Gold Status. And let's click Save. Now we can remove the filter. And whenever we want to apply it again, we can simply select Data, then change view and select our saved filter. So filters help us drill down, but sometimes the problem is messy data. Let's quickly clean that up by removing duplicates. If you've imported or copied data into Google Sheets, there are times when there might be duplicates. We're going to clean these up. Let's select all of the cells in this sheet. Now let's select Data, then Data Cleanup, and select Remove Duplicates. Make sure the correct columns are selected, then choose Remove Duplicates. Now our sheet only includes unique values for the email column. The only issue with using this option is that we can't review the duplicates. It just removes them straight away. So let's undo this change. Now let's select Data again, then Data Cleanup, and this time let's select Cleanup Suggestions. We can now see suggestions listed on the right, and this lets us review the duplicates. And we can choose to ignore or remove the duplicates. This gives you more control when working with your spreadsheet. Now, once your data is clean, you might want to see the trends, including any unexpected spikes or dips. A great way to do that is by adding sparklines. Sparklines let us add tiny charts that fit inside a cell. They're perfect for showing quick trends. Let's select a cell where we want to see the sparkline. Now start typing equal sparkline and select the sparkline option. Now we can select the cells that contain the data we want to use. And then we press Enter. That's it. We've added a sparkline to our spreadsheet. Sparklines make your sheet more visual and can provide quick insights if there are trends in your data. Okay, now let's look at something that can make you faster and more efficient. We're going to look at shortcuts, including keyboard shortcuts. Shortcuts make it much faster to navigate and work inside Google Sheets. Let's ensure the cell with our sparkline is selected. On the bottom right corner of the cell, you'll notice a small blue dot. When you hover over this, your cursor will change to a cross. When the cross appears, you can click and drag to copy the formula or value into the other cells. We now have a sparkline for all of the rows in our sheet. Keyboard shortcuts can also be super helpful. For example, if you have a cell selected, you can quickly select the entire column by pressing Shift and then Space, or Control and then Space on a Mac. You can also use keyboard shortcuts to quickly change formatting. For example, we can select the cells we want to change. Then click Ctrl Shift and 4 to change the formatting to currency, or Ctrl Shift and 5 for percent, or Ctrl Shift and 1 for numbers. And to quickly jump to the end of a row or column, you can press Ctrl and one of the arrows on your keyboard, or on a Mac, Command and an arrow. This lets you quickly jump up, down, left and right in your spreadsheet. And to view all of the available shortcuts, press Alt and forward slash, or Command and forward slash on a Mac. So shortcuts can save you time when working with Google Sheets. And if you want to organize the data in your spreadsheet, a great way to do this is using a table. Tables make the data in your spreadsheet easier to manage. To do this, let's right-click and choose Convert to Table. We can rename the table, set column types, and apply a color theme. And if you want to stop using a table, you can select the small arrow to the right of the table name and choose Revert to Unformatted Data. Tables are great inside one sheet, but what if your data is spread across different spreadsheets? That's where the import range formula comes in. If our data is split across multiple spreadsheets, we can pull data from one spreadsheet into another one. To do this, let's select a cell. Now let's start typing equals import range, and let's select the import range option. Then we add opening quotes and paste the URL of the other spreadsheet. And closing quotes, comma, quotes. Then we enter the name of the sheet followed by an exclamation mark and the range we want to import. Quotes, closing parenthesis, and press enter. The data from that sheet now appears in our current one. Importing lets you combine existing data, but sometimes you might need to collect new data. Google Forms makes this really simple. Google Forms works seamlessly with Google Sheets. You can even create a new form so it's connected to your existing spreadsheet. To do this, select Tools and choose Create a New Form. You can now add questions and set up your new form. And when you head back to your spreadsheet, we can see a new tab has been created. So our new form is automatically linked to our spreadsheet. Once people start submitting your form, you'll see all of the responses appear in this new sheet. From there, you can analyze results using filters, charts, and all of the other options we've covered. So we can use Google Forms to collect responses directly into our spreadsheet. Apart from Forms, you might want to extend Google Sheets by connecting it to other platforms and tools. And this is why you might want to use add-ons. Add-ons let us connect Google Sheets with other tools. Let's choose Extensions, then Add-ons, and Get Add-ons. We can then look for the tool we want to use and install it. For example, we can use Google's GA4 Report Builder to pull data in from Google Analytics. Or we can use the Data Slayer add-on to import campaign data for our ads on Facebook. Or maybe you want to pull in profile data from LinkedIn. Or connect another platform to your spreadsheet. Add-ons help bring more data into Google Sheets. Then you might decide you want to visualize your data and share it. You can create dashboards directly in Google Sheets, but for more customization options, you can use Looker Studio. Looker Studio is Google's data visualization tool. You can head to Looker Studio to build your report from scratch, or you can create a report from inside Google Sheets. To do this, select Extensions, then Looker Studio, and select Create a Report. You can now select the sheet you want to use and select some additional options. I'm going to leave the defaults and click Create. A new report will now be automatically created using your spreadsheet as the data source. You can then edit this report. You can use Looker Studio to create single-page dashboards and multi-page reports. And you can even connect multiple data sources for more advanced reporting needs. Looker Studio turns a basic spreadsheet into a powerful reporting solution. So there are 10 awesome things you can do with Google Sheets, from cleaning and highlighting your data through to integrating with forms and building dashboards in Looker Studio. Which one are you going to try first? Let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like more, check out my blog post where I cover even more Google Sheets tips. You can find a link in the description. And if you found this video helpful, please like it and subscribe to this channel for all of my latest tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.